Hi, welcome to the video presentation on virgin coconut oil composition overview, brought to you by virgincoconutoilmalaysia.com. Now, first of all, I believed we need to know the exact virgin coconut oil composition in order for us to understand the power and the potency of the VCO or virgin coconut oil. And this is probably the most basic and essential information we all need to have in order to have meaningful discussion on more interesting topics, such as how virgin coconut oil is good for you, how does it help you in your heart health, and so on and so forth. Now, first of all, understanding fats and oils. Now, fats and oils are terms which are used interchangeably. Okay, fats, however, often being used to refer to solid, whereas oils mostly refer to liquid. Okay, sometimes lipids are also used by doctor or, you know, more technical people, which means fats and oils basically. Now, there's another more proper or rather more scientific term is called fatty acids. Now, what are fatty acids? Fatty acids are the oil components of any oils, okay? They are the basic units of fats and oils, or lipids. Now, different oils have different fatty acids contents. The fatty acids are classified, the different fatty acids are classified based on various factors such as the size of the fatty acids, the saturation of the fatty acids, the bonding of the fatty acids, so on and so forth, okay? You probably heard of terms like saturated and unsaturated oils or fatty acids, okay? Now, what are saturated versus unsaturated fatty acids? Now, the top diagram here, as you can see, all the carbon has one dash connected to hydrogen, okay? And the one below, as you see, two of the carbon atoms has actually a double dash or the equal sign, and with some hydrogen missing. And this double sign here or the equal sign here between the carbon atoms are referred to as double bond, okay, represented by two dashes. Okay, now the one on top, there is no double bond, okay, there is no presence of any double bond. And in this case, we refer to the fatty acids as saturated fatty acids. And the presence of double bond in the fatty acids, we classified it as unsaturated fatty acids. Basically, what it means is this, okay? Now, the unsaturated fatty acids with the double bond, it means that the carbon atoms here are not fully saturated with hydrogen, as in the case here. So, the saturated fatty acids basically means the carbon atoms are fully saturated with the hydrogen ions, okay? That is the first main difference we can see. Okay, now, so these are two big categories of fatty acids, saturated and unsaturated. Now, in the unsaturated, there is actually subdivided into two big categories, and they are known as monounsaturated and polyunsaturated. In this case here, you can see one double bond, and this particular fatty acids would be classified as monounsaturated fatty acids because there is only one double bond, mono, one double bond, mono, monounsaturated fatty acids. Let's say if there's one double bond here and there's another double bond here, there'd be more than one double bond, and it would be classified as polyunsaturated fatty acids, okay? So that is basically how you classify the different fatty acids based on the presence of different factors, and one particular one is the double bond. And of course, these two molecules, these two fatty acids here are drawn to be equal, okay? In reality, there are different types of fatty acids that would have, you know, this one is only have so many carbon atoms. There are others that are shorter, C2, C4, C6, C16, C18, C24, and so on. Those would be the different sizes of the fatty acids, okay? Now, First of all, the double bond in the unsaturated fatty acids are considered weak bond, okay? The bonding between the carbon atoms are weak. What does that mean? A weak bond means that they are subject or more susceptible to oxidation and formation of free radicals. So essentially what will happen is when hydrogen ions come along, you can break the double bond because it's a weak bond, okay? You break this double bond here and attach themselves to saturate the carbon atom where the double bond has been broken or is broken, okay? So hydrogen ions can come along and attack, okay, the double bond and break it up and then attach themselves to the carbon and then becomes saturated fatty acid, okay? So that is what it means. On the contrary, the saturated fatty acids, there is no presence of double bond. So even there are hydrogen ions floating around or whatever it is, there is no place for them to saturate the fatty acids because they are all full up. They are fully saturated. So in other words, saturated fatty acids, they are not susceptible to oxidation, okay? Because of that, there is it will not lead to the formation of free radicals. That is one concept that we need to grasp, okay? Unsaturated fatty acids, very susceptible to oxidation and lead to formation of free radicals. Saturated fatty acids, they are not susceptible to oxidation and therefore it doesn't lead to the formation of free radicals, okay? These concepts are very important in subsequent discussion and future discussion. I hope you grasp that, okay? Because you often see label, you know, in your food or in oils, you see saturated content, you see polyunsaturated content, monounsaturated content, okay? So what does that mean to you? And now, of course, you'll see terms like trans fatty acids. We'll go into all this in more detail in future articles, okay? But you need to grasp the concept of saturation and unsaturation. Saturated fatty acids and unsaturated fatty acids. One is easy to be oxidized, which is the unsaturated because of the double bond, because the hydrogen ions are not filled up the space. There are space for hydrogen ions to go in and attach themselves there. So they are easier to be oxidized and that can lead to formation of free radicals. Saturated, there's no room for hydrogen to go in. So they are not susceptible to oxidation and therefore is not easily lead to the formation of free radicals. That is two very, very important characteristics of the two different fatty acids or two different oils, okay? Now this table basically compares the fatty acid content or the composition of the different edible oils, coconut oil, palm oil, olive oil, soybean oil, corn oil, sunflower oil, safflower oil, canola oil. Now the first one, as we see, this column basically all the different oils, and the next three columns here basically state percentage of the different type of fatty acids. First one here is saturated fatty acids, and then followed by percent of monounsaturated, and then the last column is polyunsaturated fatty acids percentage in the oil. Okay, now coconut oil has the highest percent of saturated fatty acids with about 6% monounsaturated and 2% polyunsaturated. On the other end of the spectrum, the last row of the table, canola oil, which is a rapeseed oil, okay, it has the lowest percentage of saturated fatty acids with a fairly high percentage of monounsaturated and medium content of polyunsaturated. If we look somewhere up, soybean, corn oil, sunflower, safflower, you can find that they have a fairly high percentage of polyunsaturated with the fairly low saturated fatty acids. Now olive oil is often referred to as monounsaturated oil. That is because it has a very high percentage of monounsaturated with a much lower amount of saturated fatty acids and polyunsaturated acids. Now one fact we need to point out here, even though sometimes we call an oil such as olive oil is monounsaturated, doesn't mean that it doesn't have any saturated or polyunsaturated. So this is just a simply fine way of naming things, okay? It's an oversimplification of what is actually in the oil. Same thing as coconut oil, it has always been labeled as a saturated oil, which in gross term is not wrong, because it has 92% of saturated fatty acids with a fairly small amount of unsaturated fatty acids. Now, what's the point of all this? Now, I think most of us probably have the concept that, or we have been told, or you know, we have heard from media or read from articles or learned from university that unsaturated oils are good for you. Okay, saturated oils such as those in coconut oil and palm oil are bad for you. They are bad for your heart. They are bad for your cholesterol. I think this is the primary message that most of us have in our mind, and that's why in most of our home we probably find things like, you know, vegetable oil and bean oil, you know. Most of us probably use canola oil or sunflower oil or even corn oil or soybean oil. This is the trend that, or this is the current, you know, understanding of most of the people, that vegetable oil is good for you, coconut oil is bad for you. Okay, now I'm going to tell you that the reverse is true. Okay, we have been told lies. Okay, there is a reason for it, and in upcoming articles I'm going to talk about all this, okay, the history of how coconut oil has been defamed, okay, how commercialism have deliberately, probably out of greed and commercial profit reasons, that coconut oil and tropical oils as a group has been labeled as bad, okay, and I tell you loud and clear right now, that is not true, those are lies, okay, and once you understand the scientific evidence behind it, you will probably want to throw away all the rest of the oils, especially things like all the vegetable oil and the oils. The olive oil is a fairly good oil, depending on how you use it. Palm oil is a fairly good oil as well. But coconut oil is definitely the best oil among here, okay? And the future article will explain in details why coconut oil is good for you and why the other oils are bad for you, okay? So I hope you look forward to those articles, because these are really paradigm shifting articles that we really have to step back and look at the scientific evidence. Why saturated fatty acids, as in coconut oil, are good for us, okay? Why polyunsaturated or unsaturated fatty acids are no good for us, okay? So we're going to talk in details about those, and I hope you really look out for those articles and videos so that you can make a reverse, okay? Or rather make a big difference in your health after you know the truth, okay? So I want to thank you for taking the time to watch this video, and I really, really hope you view the upcoming videos. It's coming very, very soon, okay? Once again, thank you, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.